Do you want to become rich and adopt me in 2024? Follow these tips and I promise you, you will upgrade your inventory. Hey stars, it's Stella. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing how to get rich and adopt me. This is not me saying that I am rich in any way. I do not think I am rich, but this is just like a video on how to upgrade and improve your inventory. So I've been playing for a long time, ever since I think the Safari egg. So I've like had a lot of time playing Adopt Me, obviously. So I feel like I've got some good tips to share. So let's just get on with it and yeah, let's just get started. Okay, stars, my first tip would be to steal pets from your siblings. So I just all the time, this is just kind of how I got rich. I just kind of take all of their pets, most of their pets, and it's really helped me build up my inventory. So I would really suggest you do this. Do not steal from people. That's very mean. And do not scam. Do not scam. No scam is allowed. Anyway, let's get on to my real first tip. Okay, so my real first tip is to complete training challenges. So training challenges, I personally hate them because they are so freaking annoying, but they do help you. And for something like a common to legendary challenge, even if you fail and you don't get a legendary, you still end up with a better pet than what you started. Even if you go from a common to a rare, that's still better and you've still upgraded your inventory. Okay, so my second tip is to know the value of the pet that you're training. So you do not want to be trading a pet and not know the value of it and then get a bad trade. So an example of that would be maybe you're trading like an owl and you trade it for something that's not worth an owl, and you then like you've lost the value in your inventory and you've done a lose trade, and it's not fun, it's not a good time, and yeah, it's just not fun. My third tip is to not trade for pets that are low in demand. So do not trade for pets, griffins, oxes, minion chicks, anything like that. Please just do not. Even if it's mega, even if you think it seems like a win, it's not a win because everyone hates those pets. And also things that are just kind of hard to trade in general. My fourth tip is to make sure you know values. This kind of like goes in with the second one, but for anyone that needs help with values, I use the Adopt Me values.gg. I think that's what it is. Maybe it's Adopt Me training values. I'll put it on the screen, and it really helps me because before I was using a different one that was very not accurate, and I watched a video similar to this and I found that, and it really helps me a lot. Okay, my next tip is to trade with your friends. When you trade with your friends, normally, if they're good friends, they will give you something that is worth your pet or even worth more. And I love that. I love trading with my friends. And also, I feel safer trading with my friends because I know that if I want to, like, I could most likely get it back unless they trade it. So that's also, like, comforting knowing that. Okay, so my next tip is to get early on updates and get the best offers. I'm not really good at doing this because when the Adopt Me updates come, it is like 3 a.m. in Australia, so that's not really fun, and I'm not really good at then going in Australia getting the good pets. But especially if the updates come in a good time for you, you should try to get on it really fast and try to get as many good pets as you can, trade them for overpays, because those really work. I've never done that, but I've seen that work with a lot of my friends and a lot of YouTubers that I watch that works for them. So that's a tip that I would have. I try to do that every time there's a new update. I kind of fail because, again, I'm a bit late since I don't wake up for like many hours later, but that's fine. Anyway, my seventh tip is to build for pets. But building for pets really helps my inventory. It's something that's made me grow a lot, and I just love building for pets anyway. It's something that I love doing. And I also think it's good to like do things that you love. So I'm definitely more of a builder than a grinder. I don't really like making megas and neons. I'd rather build for the megas and neons, not grind for them. I don't think I've ever made a mega. I've only made like a few neons. I'm really not a good grinder, but that's okay. That's probably why I'm not very rich, but so yeah, that's my next tip, is to grind with your friends and make megas and neons. I'm really bad at this tip, but I'm trying to get better right now. I'm trying to make a neon dotted eggy and a mega what's it called? Arctic hair, because I saw Lottie have it and I was like, that's the cutest thing ever. And then she gave me a bunch. So now I'm making a mega of that. Anyway, so that's what I'm trying to do now. I'm trying to get better at that. So I suggest that you do the same because it's very much how you grow your inventory. I think that's what has stopped me from having a better inventory. My next tip is to buy eggs from the gumball machine and hatch them with your friends, or even just trade the eggs, especially like when they first come out again. You can trade lots of the eggs for overpays. But yeah, the gumball machine does change, so I suggest like to get them and save them. Right now in my inventory, I think I've got a royal egg and I've got two urban eggs and I've got a mythic egg. I think these were all gifts. Or no, these two were gifts from fans, which thank you so much. And I've also got this bat box, which I'm saving for a long time, and hopefully that will be one day worth a lot. It's not too old right now, but one day it'll probably be worth a lot. So I am just saving that for when it is. So I suggest you do the same. So, because then, like, obviously, like, things like safari eggs and jungle eggs right now get really big overpays and they get really good offers. So, you obviously want to do that. So, whenever I get an egg, I'm like trying from now on to like at least save one of them for a long time, as long as I can. But yeah, my last tip is to have fun and to not compare yourself to your friends and other players. This is really hard for me because I have been playing for a long time and lots of my friends have like neon mega high tiers and I don't. But I think that it's really good to just play for fun and make neons and megas, make whatever pet you want, neon or mega. And this doesn't mean doing happy values and getting things, but honestly, if you want to do have to use happy values, then you can. And it's just whatever makes you happy. You obviously don't want to like burn out and just not like the game anymore. So, you just need to like have fun and keep to yourself and not let anyone else like make you feel like you're not good enough or anything like that. But yeah, a little bit of a TED talk right there. You're welcome. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed these tips. I kind of just like sat down and talked this whole video. It's giving me like podcast vibes. Presley like halfway the through. Oh my gosh, Presley halfway through just needed like a shower, so we had to do that. But yeah, I think my next video will probably be a grinding video, as I mentioned before. I'm trying to make a neon and a mega right now, so that will probably be my next video. So get ready for that. And I also want to do an Easter Sky Castle video, but I did it and then it didn't save, so I don't know if I should redo it. Or if I should maybe build my fan in Easter Sky Castle as part of the 3,000 giveaway, just let me know. Also, if you made it this far, comment a microphone emoji if there is one. I'm pretty sure there is. Hold on, let me check. Is there a microphone? Yes, there is. Okay, so if you made it this far, comment a microphone emoji just because I feel like this was like podcast vibes. Anyway, I hope you enjoy these videos. I hope that these tips can help you. They've definitely helped me. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. I love you so much. Bye.